Hi there, if you want to learn about cocaine and how it affects the brain, you've got to watch this video. So today we're continuing our series on cocaine and we're going to discuss the effect of cocaine on the brain. Now, fundamentally, cocaine alters profoundly the dopamine system. And the dopamine system plays a central role in reward motivation and also addiction. Now, these effects vary slightly depending on the form of cocaine that one is ingesting. So remember, we've got cocaine hydrochloride, which is a powder, we've got freebase, and we've got crack. And these changes or differences in effects are due to differences in onset and duration. But ultimately, all roads lead to Rome, and all forms of cocaine in all methods of ingestion ultimately lead to similar neurochemical disruptions. Firstly, dopamine system and cocaine's mechanism of action. So cocaine primarily acts by blocking the dopamine transporter. This is known as DAT, DAT. And blocking DAT prevents dopamine reuptake into the presynaptic neuron. And the presynaptic neuron is the neuron that released dopamine in the first place. DAT is effectively a vacuum cleaner in the synaptic space that sucks up all the dopamine that was released. So if you block DAT, if you switch off the vacuum cleaner, you've got a buildup of dopamine in the synaptic cleft. And this results in a prolonged activation of dopaminergic receptors in the postsynaptic membrane and also an increased euphoria. So let's look at key steps in cocaine's dopaminergic action. So dopamine release. So normally dopamine is released from presynaptic neurons and binds to dopamine receptors, numbered 1 through 5, on the postsynaptic neuron mediating pleasure, motivation, and movement. Now, dopaminergic reuptake inhibition blocks the Hoover and increases dopamine concentrations in the synaptic cleft. This leads to overstimulation of the postsynaptic dopamine receptor. And then we have something called neurotransmitter spillover. So cocaine also inhibits the reuptake of serotonin and norepinephrine, amplifying the effects of norepinephrine and serotonin as well, and therefore causing changes in mood, arousal, and alertness. Now, too much of a good thing always is a bad thing. And of course, when you overstimulate a postsynaptic dopamine receptor, you get down regulation of that receptor. And this is a longer term effect. And with repeated use, the brain reduces dopamine receptor density to compensate for the excessive dopamine levels. This translates clinically into tolerance and anhedonia, which is the inability to feel pleasure, and addiction. And so therefore, people who are addicted to cocaine find the need to use more and more cocaine, more and more of the substance, to get the same effect, or as the addiction progresses, simply to feel normal. So that's the general principle of how cocaine works at a synaptic level. Now let's look at the effect of cocaine in specific brain regions. Now, cocaine affects multiple brain regions, but especially those involved in reward, decision-making, stress management, and motor function. So let's look at the reward pathway first of all. And the main system here is the mesolimbic dopamine system. And the key brain areas are the ventral tegmental area, and this is located in the midbrain, and the VTA, ventral tegmental area, contains dopaminergic neurons that project to other brain sites. And cocaine increases dopamine activity in the VTA, amplifying its role in reward and reinforcement. And the next region is the nucleus accumbens, the NAC. And this is the pleasure center. It's the key reward center that receives dopaminergic input from the VTA. Cocaine hyperactivates the NAC, leading to euphoria, heightened motivation, and compulsive drug-seeking behavior. The amygdala. Now, this is where we process our emotions and where we may develop cravings. The amygdala processes emotional responses, including fear, anxiety, and cravings, and cocaine-induced dopamine surges enhance drug-related memories, contributing to the cravings that you experience, especially cue-driven cravings, and therefore increases the risk of relapse back to cocaine use disorder. And then we have the hippocampus, memory formation. So the hippocampus is responsible for learning and memory, and cocaine strengthens associations between drug use and environmental cues, making relapse more likely when exposed to places or people associated with past use. So this is where the memory of previous drug use then becomes a cue or a trigger for ongoing drug use. And that's because of the memories stored in the hippocampus. So that's the mesolimbic dopaminergic system and the reward pathways. Now let's look at the mesocortical dopamine system, the decision-making and impulse control system. So the mesocortical system really is a way of describing the connection between the midbrain and the prefrontal cortex. The prefrontal cortex is where decision-making and self-control occurs. The PFC, prefrontal cortex, is responsible for impulse control, reasoning, and long-term decision-making. And cocaine use, chronic cocaine use, impairs prefrontal cortical functioning, leading to poor impulse control, compulsive drug-seeking behavior, and risk-taking behavior. We also have the anterior cingulate cortex, the ACC, and this is where we process errors and we monitor conflict. And the ACC helps detect errors and conflicts in behavior. Cocaine disrupts error processing, making users less aware of the negative consequences of their drug use. Then we have the nigrostriatal dopamine system, and this is really the motor system. And the basal ganglia, otherwise known as the striatum, are key in the development of habits. The striatum is heavily involved in motor control as well. Long-term cocaine use strengthens drug-taking habits, making cocaine use feel more automatic and harder to stop. Then we have the substantia nigra, where we have the motor function, or rather automatic motor function, and also Parkinson's-like effects. So the substantia nigra contains dopaminergic neurons that regulate movement, and chronic cocaine use damages dopaminergic neurons, increasing the risk of movement disorders similar to Parkinson's disease. So that was the movement center. Now then, let's talk about stress and arousal in the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus controls the autonomic nervous system and regulates stress, heart rate, hormone release. Cocaine triggers excessive norepinephrine release in the hypothalamus, or from the hypothalamus rather, leading to increased heart rate, blood pressure, and the risk of heart attack or stroke. So there we have it. That's the effects of cocaine in multiple sites of the brain. That's all for today, folks. My name's Dr. Ferghal Armstrong, and this has been Cracking Addiction.